My lords, pray be seated. My lords and members of the House of Commons, my government will govern in service to the country. My government's legislative programme will be mission-led and based upon the principles of security, fairness, and opportunity for all. Stability will be the cornerstone of my government's economic policy, and every decision will be consistent with its fiscal rules. It will legislate to ensure that all significant tax and spending changes are subject to an independent assessment by the Office for Budget Responsibility. Modern dynamic economy and is a key driver of economic growth. My ministers will get Britain building, including through planning reform, as they seek to accelerate the delivery of high-quality infrastructure and housing. They will also pursue sustainable growth by encouraging investment in industry, skills, and new technologies. My government is committed to making work pay and will legislate to introduce a new deal. My ministers will bring forward legislation to improve the railways by reforming rail franchising, establishing Great British Railways, and bringing train operators into public ownership. Taken together, these policies will enhance Britain's position as a leading industrial nation and enable the country to take advantage of new opportunities that can promote growth and wealth creation. My government recognises the urgency of the global climate challenge and the new job opportunities that can come from leading the development of the technologies of the future. It is committed to a clean energy transition, which will lower energy bills for consumers over time. A bill will be introduced to set up Great British Energy, a publicly owned clean power company headquartered in Scotland, which will help accelerate investment in renewable energy, such as offshore wind. Legislation will be brought forward to help the country achieve energy independence and unlock investment in energy infrastructure. A bill will be introduced to modernise the asylum and immigration system, establishing a new border security command and delivering enhanced counter-terror powers to tackle organised immigration crime. My ministers will establish an industrial strategy council. A bill will be introduced to raise standards in education and promote children's well-being. Measures will be brought forward to remove the exemption from value-added tax for private school fees, which will enable the funding of 6,500 new teachers. A bill will be introduced to allow local leaders to take control of their local bus services. A bill will be introduced to progressively increase the age at which people can buy cigarettes and impose limits on the sale and marketing of vapes. My ministers will also legislate to restrict advertising of junk food to children, along with the sale of high caffeine energy drinks to children. A draft bill will be brought forward to ban conversion practices. It will ensure mental health is given the same attention and focus as physical health. Measures to modernise the Constitution will be introduced, including House of Lords reform to remove the right of hereditary peers to sit and vote in the Lords. My ministers will strengthen the integrity of elections and encourage wide participation in the democratic process. My government will continue to give its full support to Ukraine and its people, and it will endeavour to play a leading role in providing Ukraine with a clear path to NATO membership. My government will seek to reset the relationship with European partners and work to improve the United Kingdom's trade and investment relationship with the European Union. My ministers will seek a new security pact to strengthen cooperation on the mutual threats faced by the United Kingdom and the European Union. My government will play its part in trying to secure long-term peace and security in the Middle East. It is committed to a two-state solution with a safe and secure Israel alongside a viable and sovereign Palestinian state.
I now call the Leader of the Opposition, Rishi Sunak.
Well, thank you, Mr. Speaker. And before I turn to the address, I'm sure the whole House would like to join me in paying tribute to His Majesty the King. Yeah. It is typical of his dedication to duty that despite the medical challenges he has recently faced, he was here today to open Parliament and will travel to the Commonwealth Hubs of Government meeting in Samoa and to Australia this autumn. The King is a true model of public service. Yeah. Strong addition to the other place, despite the Right Honourable Lady being already over the retirement age. And I know that the whole House will join me in deploring the assassination attempt on President Trump. Yeah. Our thoughts are with the victims. Violence and intimidation have no place in the democratic process. Yeah. I offer some words of advice to members opposite. On the government benches, life comes at you fast. Soon you might be fortunate enough to be tapped on the shoulder and offered a junior ministerial role. Then you'll find yourself attending cabinet, then in the cabinet, and then when the Prime Minister's position becomes untenable, you might end up being called to the highest office. And before you know it, you have a bright future behind you, and you are left wondering whether you can credibly be an elder statesman at the age of 44. And when it comes to legal migration, I urge the Home Secretary to retain the measures that we all wish to see our country and our people flourish and succeed. And in that spirit, I wish the new Prime Minister and the new government well.
Yeah. I now call the Prime Minister, Sir Keir Starmer.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Before we begin, may I join the Leader of the Opposition in his tribute to His Majesty the King. It is so heartening to see him in his rightful place delivering the gracious speech. And I'm sure the whole House will not mind once again wishing him a speedy recovery. Yeah. Can I also join in wishing Her Majesty the Queen a happy birthday? Mr. Speaker, we also wish President Trump a speedy recovery from the appalling attempt on his life at the weekend. I spoke with President Trump on Sunday night to pass our best wishes, but also to share our revulsion at the senseless violence which has no place in democracy. Mr. Speaker, I also want to congratulate the England football team for their achievements in the Euros, something the Leader of the Opposition and I were talking about this morning. Yes, the trophy eluded us again, but the team can be proud of another exceptional performance, something I'm sure the whole House would be only too pleased to recognise. And we pay tribute to Gareth Southgate, who shouldered the burden of national leadership with such dignity. Mr. Speaker, this government has been elected to deliver nothing less than national renewal, to stop the chaos of the past 14 years, turn the page on an era of politics as noisy performance, and return it to public service, and start the work of rebuilding our country. A determined rebuilding, a patient rebuilding, a calm rebuilding. A rejection in this complicated and volatile world of those who can only offer the easy answer, the snake oil charm of populism. Mr. Speaker, as the last 14 years has shown, that road is a dead end for this country. It does nothing to fix our foundations, and the British people have rejected it, as they have throughout our history. What people really want is change, and change is what this government of service will deliver. A King's Speech that takes the brakes off our economy and shows to the British people that politics can be a force for good, the vehicle for improving lives of millions, no matter who you voted for. I said that we would serve everyone, whether they voted for us or not, and I meant it. So let me say directly to the benches opposite, if you're invested in the success of your community, we will work with you. This is a new era. We are turning the page, returning politics to service, because that is what the people of this country want to see from their politicians. And service is a stronger bond than political self-interest. Yeah. That is what country first means. The only way we can restore trust, and the reason this government of service was elected.